We got a fight right here. Oh my gosh. Absolute giant snook right there. All right, guys, good morning and welcome back to another video today. So a lot of people have been asking me in comments and just Instagram, how do I catch live mullet? So well, not exactly how do I catch them, what are the tricks, because they're having trouble. So I'm gonna show you guys my tricks or my techniques today to finding them. And we're fishing a new area, so this will be a good example. I have no clue where to look. I do see some flickers and jumps right up on the shoreline, so I'm gonna start here. But yeah, we're gonna hop right into it. Alrighty, guys, so I went ahead and prepped up the cast net right here. But I'll tell you guys a few tips. A lot of times I'll look for mullet in that like 1 to 2 foot depth, which is right behind me. That's basically like the sweet spot for me where I find them and I'm able to cast net them the easiest. If they're deeper water, a lot of times they'll go under the cast net. And then too shallow water, you can't get in with the trolling motor. So that 1 to 2 foot depth is the best spot. So I have my 8 foot cast net here. This is a 3/4 mesh or a 3/8 mesh. And we're gonna basically just go ahead and pull up on the flat and look for them. I'll just look with my eyes. Maybe I'll look for the actual mullet swimming along, or I'll just look for the like the wakes they'll push off when they take off. A lot of times they're very good at keeping their distance from the boat. So it's sometimes difficult, sometimes it's easy. It just kind of depends. But we're just gonna go ahead and see what happens right here. We'll see how many there are actually behind me. First cast was a failure. Just got a bunch of tiny mahara. I must have missed them. So we got our first mullet right here. Hopefully you guys can see that. That is a black mullet, aka striped mullet. Let me see if I can show you guys. Yep, you guys can see those stripes right there. That is a dead giveaway. They're also a little bit darker in the head. And we're gonna throw this guy, he's probably 12 inches. We're gonna put him in the bucket, but I basically just got him on a blind cast there. That was pretty lucky. They're not as thick as I thought, but this guy will be great bait for a giant snook. All right, so there's a really nice sandbar right behind me. I noticed that some kind of heron flew over them, and mullet was just taking off everywhere, spooking from the shadow of the bird. So that's one other good thing to look for, is when birds fly really low over the water, or just over the water in general, a shadow will spook up mullet really easily. So that's exactly what I saw right there. We're gonna turn around, grab the cast net, and hopefully they'll be easy grabs. There we go, we're finding them. We got like six right there. Maybe more. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Let's go. These guys, I don't know if you can see that from here, these guys are more like the 6 inchers, perfect size for snook, redfish, tarpon. All right, I wanna try to show you guys exactly what I'm seeing here since I got 10 mullet in the bucket now, and that's enough for a 5 gallon bucket. So I'll show you guys what I was seeing here on the sandbar. All right, so as you guys can see here, there's a barrier island right there, and then this glassy spot right here is a sandbar coming out, right? And there's a trough just on the other side of the glassy water there. And they're just absolutely loaded in there. I wish maybe a bird could fly over right now so you could see how many there really are, but just millions. And of course they show up. And of course I find them after I've been throwing for about an hour, but it's probably 8:30 in the morning right now, but it's time to start fishing, guys. So we got our mullet, we're ready to go. Hopefully you guys learned something about catching mullet. and let's catch a big fish.
One snook on him. Missed him. That's a giant. So I'm switched up mullet here. We got a giant mullet on. This is a good bait for the giant fish. He just inhaled it. Nope. Didn't get the whole thing. Watch this. Behemoth. Behemoth. Yep, got him. Behemoth. Oh, we got a fight right here. Behemoth. Go out in the open. Go out in the open, baby. We're gonna chase him. We gotta keep him away from the dock here. Get this fish out in the open water. Pump, pumping reel, pumping reel. Gotta keep pulling her out in the open. Giant, giant fish, giant snook. What did I say about that mullet? What did I say? Big mullet, big fish. My jump here. God, she's 20, 30, 40 feet away from this dock here. I'm just trying my best to get any space here. Maybe loosen up drag a tight a little bit. Oh my behemoth snook, dude. Come off the drag just a little bit. Holy crap. I'm shaking right now. Come off the drag just a tad bit more. We're out in open water. Oh my gosh. Giant. Giant. We're gonna pull her up to the shoreline here. Check that out. Steer her up here real shallow. We're gonna land her up there. All right, here we go, guys. Oh my gosh. Absolute giant snook right there. First fish of the year, first real snook of the year. And it took a while, man. A lot of hard work to get this fish. A perfect hook set right there. I'm going to, let me grab the camera right here. I'm gonna lift her up one time here for the camera, and then we're going to measure her and release, but oh, holy crap. Absolute giant fish. Probably 41, 42, maybe 40 on the dot, can't really tell, but probably 25 pound fish. And go ahead and get a ruler, or we're gonna get a measure on this fish and then go ahead and release. All right, hopefully I have my ruler in here. Good, we do have it. So this big girl, go ahead and unhook her, and then we're gonna go lay her on the sand, see how big she is. Giant fish either way. Most of the time I wouldn't measure fish, but for the sake of the video, people like to see the measurement so they know I'm not lying. Oh, perfect hook set, best you could ask for right there. All right, we're gonna do this as quick as possible here. Straight from the water over to the ruler. We got zero on that side, all the way down to 42 and a half. Yep, 42 right there, half inch mark right there. Beauty, back in the water she goes. Let's go, guys. Back in the water she goes. Look at this beautiful girl. Oh, all right, we're turning around here. Look at how big the tail is, insane. First big fish of the year. Came in July, took a minute, but we found her. Pretty insane. Oh, come on. These fish fight hard. They will fight pretty much to the death. So you gotta take your time reviving them. Absolutely amazing fish. Come on, girl. Come on, girl. There she goes. There's the wake up. All right, probably gonna cruise back into under a dock and then kill some more mullet later tonight. Just gonna keep an eye on her. I see her cruising down the shoreline just to make sure everything's okay. Cruising right here, come here, girl. Oh, yeah, won't let me grab her again. A lot of times big fish do that. You'll see them cruising away, chilling, and then you'll go to just double check on them, they blast off. That's insane. That snook was huge. Check our release ruler here. These rulers are pretty neat. I'll leave a link in the description if you guys want to check them out. They're waterproof. They got huge numbers on them, and they tell you approximate weight of a fish. So you see here, 39 to 40 was 24 to 28 pounds. And you can only imagine what a 42 and a half inch fish would be. Pretty nuts.
Oof. We in focus? Yep, here we go. All right, well, end of today's video, guys. I didn't have much action after that 42 and a half freaking giant. I actually did have one blow up on a topwater, but after that snook, I didn't have any other action. So I hope you guys enjoyed that. That was biggest snook of the year. I don't think it was the biggest snook of my life. I think the one I caught one last year that I thought was just a tad bit bigger. But either way, humongous snook, just giant, amazing fish. And what we get it on? We got him on the that first mullet this morning, that like 13, 14 incher that I cast netted. That was the mullet that the fish ate, but pretty neat either way. I hope you guys learned something about cast netting mullet today, and maybe learned something about catching big snook. And other than that, if you guys are new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up. Let's go for 500 likes on this video. Make that a goal. Yeah.